Hey guys, today I'd like to show you how to make a no-sew mask. That is something that should be pretty decent, pretty efficient, comfortable, somewhat durable, pretty durable, and pretty out of readily available materials. I've been doing my research to try to come up with something that people can make with things they have in their house. So I saw a cool video of an Italian lady. Maybe I'll put a quick clip of it in here. She folded up a kitchen paper towel, stapled a couple rubber bands on it. Boom, instant containment mask. That's gonna keep your breath and your vapors, your droplets to yourself. Okay, and that's gonna keep us from spreading this thing around. When I saw that, I looked at it and I looked at how maybe I could improve that design. I made one for myself. And then I realized that actually what I have and what a lot of people have is shop towels. Now, shop towel is just a heavy duty paper towel that a lot of people will use as rags in their garage. And, you know, here's an example. There's different brands. This is Scott's shop towel. Okay. So Scott's shop towels, picked this up at Walmart. There were still plenty on the shelf. I think I paid $3.50 or $4 for the pack of two. Each roll has 55 towels. That's 110 towels total. It would be 110 masks. Improve the design a little bit by adding a little bendy piece here to conform to your nose. And then you've got the rubber bands to go around your ear. And your ears stick out like a goofball, depending on how you've got it adjusted. And there you can see with the nose piece, it fits here. What's crucial with these masks, it's not crucial. What's crucial is that we're containing our fluids as best we can so we're not spreading this disease around. But if you are, of course, you know, you want as efficient a mask as possible to maybe protect you. And, you know, without a proper seal, any mask like this is very ineffective. And by adding the nose piece, I'm able to conform to the shape of my face and not have the big gaps I would otherwise have here. And you can see as I breathe, you can see that you can really feel that it's working. And I find this easier to breathe through. It's not easy to breathe through, but it's easier to breathe through than a N95 mask. If you're out there and you're hoarding N95 masks and you think that you need them for yourself, it's not pleasant. You don't want to spend a whole day in one of those. Okay, so you want to turn those in to somebody that can really need them, that's definitely exposed to the virus. And for people that need to go to the grocery store or something, you want to protect everybody else and maybe even protect yourself with something like this. Okay, so let's go into making it. So first thing you want to do, you want to peel yourself off paper towel. Okay, and I like to use, it seems to fit a little better if you use the ripped ends on the side. This paper is pressed and it seems to be somewhat directional. And so what we're going to need is shop towels, paper clips. These are number one size paper clips, but these are just the smaller size of the two sides people tend to be familiar with. And then rubber bands. You can use the stuff you have in your junk drawer. I got these, they're number 32s, and I'll post links in the description to all of this stuff. But most of this is stuff that people tend to have in their house. And you're going to unbend the paper clip. And then you're going to realize you need to put on your reading glasses. Okay, here we go. Okay, you just bend it as straight as you can. But, and then the last, just like half an inch, you're going to want to bend that around and it'll scrunch to a loop like that. Okay, can you see that? And do the same on the other side. If you can get them going the same direction, that's great, but it's not necessary. The main purpose for this is so it doesn't poke through the towel, cause a hole, scratch your face, make it annoying, okay? So that's about what you want there. Okay. So then you're going to lay that out, center it up right at the edge. Take a piece of tape, a nice long piece. Put it right along the edge here. Tape it down. The only purpose for the tape is to hold that. Once we fold it all up, you just want to hold that in place so it doesn't slide side to side. And then take it right where the paper clip is, fold it over. And this is the trickiest part. You're going to make a little tight, kind of a tight fold, maybe almost more of a roll. Do it again, second time. Okay. Okay, and then a third time. Okay, and that's your nose piece. Then you're just going to fold it back and forth like an accordion. You're going to go pretty, I went pretty big. First I went about 3/4 of an inch to try to get the nose piece centered up because I'm a little anal retentive about stuff like that. And then the second fold, you'll make it so that the whole mask ends up being about an inch wide. It doesn't have to be exact at all. The whole purpose of this is just to make it so that it can expand around your mouth, but it's smaller around your cheeks. We'll see what I mean here in a minute. Just keep folding it back and forth. When you get near the end, just kind of split the difference, what you got here. And there you go. That's what you're going for. You got it folded back and forth. You got the nose piece right here. And you got it squished flat. Okay, so then what I like to do is I get my stapler. It's our office stapler. It says no kids. We had issues. So what you want to do is you'll come in about... about an inch from the edge I found is pretty good, but I've got a really big head, so maybe a little closer in if you've got a smaller head, and you can even cut some off to shorten it. You may have to experiment. Kids. Okay, do that on both sides. That pretty much locks it down. Then you don't have to be so gentle with it. Make sure you're getting everything in there. Then you're going to find the end here, and you're going to split it just roughly in the middle. You're going to find a spot. I like that spot. And you'll just tear that paper towel just a little bit up to where the staple is, okay? And what that's going to do for you is that's going to be where we put our rubber band. You put it in here, as such. Fold it over. You just keep it going this way for now. You'll go ahead and put 2 staples on the whole width of the mask. See? Just like that. Same to the other side. Right here. Put it in there. Oh, I ran out of staples. Oh my God, that is a disaster in there. This is the time we're going to clean out the junk drawer. Okay, back to the stapling. Okay, so that's what you're going to look like on each side. Let's here, I'm going to get that in the camera. See that? You got staples going all the way across. It doesn't have to be super perfect. It could be a little sloppy. If you've got a smaller head, you might find going in this way and cutting off some excess might suit you. All right, there you're done. So then you're just gonna expand it out a little bit. Okay, see, now it makes that nice mask shape. And I found that if you fold it up like this, okay,
as such. Put it over your ears. Pull down over your chin.
And this stuff is pretty tough. This isn't really like a normal paper towel. And then go ahead and bend it around your nose.
Okay. And if you do that,
take my glasses off. If you do that, you can see a nice, nice tight seal. You actually move in the paper. I can pull it away from my mouth and have a little room in there to talk. It's actually feels very comparable. I would say it maybe even feels like it seals a little better than a regular medical mask. You know, these medical masks that you're hearing so much about, they have really good filtration capabilities. But the big thing, and you've got a little bendy piece if you're going to wear one of these, you've got a little bendy piece for the nose. Make sure you use that for your nose and conform it. But it's hard to get a decent seal on one of these either. And if you don't have a decent seal, you know, you're letting air in around your mask and it's not nearly as effective. It doesn't really matter. If you're letting a bunch of air in and out of your mask, then it's the filter material itself isn't going to make nearly as much difference. All right, well, I hope you can use that, and I'd like to see everybody wearing these. Okay, thanks. Bye.